Have you heard the story of the ship's captain who was sailing late at night? Suddenly sees a light on his radar. It's on a collision course with his own ship. He tells the radio man to send this message: alter your course 10 degrees south. The message comes back: alter your course 10 degrees south. Well, the captain gets mad and he radios back: alter your course, I'm a commander. The response: alter your course, I'm a seaman third class. Well, now the captain, he's furious. He radios back: alter your course, I'm a battleship. The response: alter your course, I'm a lighthouse. You see, no matter who we are in this life or how good we think we are at living, God's directions are always going to trump our own. So either we alter our course in line with God's, or we're going to end up shipwrecked. We're either going to let His light guide us, or we're going to continue to stumble along in the dark, maybe on a collision course with who knows what. So as we begin this new year, 2022, let's make sure of our direction. I want to share again the scripture from yesterday's message. Jesus, He's wrapping up the Sermon on the Mount. And in the 7th chapter of Matthew, Jesus has told us about the narrow and the wide gate, about good and bad teachers. And now He focuses our attention on two types of builders. So Jesus is referring to the way that you and I choose to build our lives, and then what happens depending on what we choose for our foundation. I'm picking it up in verse 24. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down and the streams rose and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall. Why? Because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And the rains came down and the streams rose and the winds blew and beat against that house. And it fell with a great crash. I'm telling you, my friends, there's no reason for any of us to crash. Let's follow God's direction and then we're good. So again, as we enter into this new year, I'm inviting you to join us for 21 days of prayer and fasting. It starts today. We're going to be very intentional about seeking God's direction for the coming year, because we believe that one of the best ways for us to do that is to pray and fast. Again, if you're not sure what that looks like for you, no problem. Our team has developed this booklet for the 21 days that will help give you and our church a focus for these 21 days. It's also on the booklet. The booklet's also on the website, mynw.cc. We've also included some other resources there about prayer and fasting. So I know this is going to be a stretch for some of you, but stretch yourself. Seek His direction for you, your family, our church, and our world. Hey, let's do that. Do this in 2022.